Now, KSBW Weather Plus with Jim Vanderzwan.
Well, in case you slept in a little bit, we woke up to plenty of fog and low clouds well into the valleys. Didn't take too long, though. We get it into motion, and it cleared off, and it hasn't come back yet. It's looking really nice out there. Marine inversion layer just high enough to get stirred up just a little bit. It's temporary condition. Of course, it is July after all. 80 degrees, Boulder Creek, Ben Lomond, Scotts Valley, darn close in Santa Cruz, 76 at one time. Watsonville made it up to 72. Most lows were in the 50s. Mid-60s around the Monterey Peninsula landed about where we figured. 70 in Big Sur today, and we ended up with plenty of 70s in the Salinas Valley and a couple of 80s in Greenfield and King City, so nice and warm there, but still a little bit below normal, but no complaints. Saw it nice in Santa Clara Valley, a few 90s out in the Central Valley and some triple digits out in the deserts, but nothing too hot around here. Get on the other side of the Continental Divide, suddenly it starts getting warm. In fact, even before that, Boise up to 100 today, 100 in Dallas, 95 in Chicago, 91 in New York. This is muggy heat. This is dry heat. There is a difference because the heat index usually isn't that dramatic. Big high pressure. Next 5 days, it's only moving slowly eastward. The left flank of it will expand as an upper-level low-pressure trough goes through. This is a pressure pattern at 18,000 feet. But this heat wave that's going on in other parts of the country, it's going to go on for another week in a lot of places. Meanwhile, a little swirl of an upper-level low coming through here. That's going to go north of us, but it'll push the stratus back in later on tonight. And we'll likely see it beginning to form once it cools off. It'll likely be later in arriving than it was last night. Should back off, then come back in. Microcast picking up on that trend. We're sticking with that onshore flow. By Tuesday, it may be a little bit thicker. It's going to kind of come and go vary just a little bit by a few degrees, too, over the next couple of days. And then later in the week, it may just warm up a little bit, but only get close to normal. So we're not looking at any hot weather. Bay Area temperatures comfortable, 70s and 80s in the Santa Clara and Salinas Valleys tomorrow. Again, your lows will end up in the 50s, so you get good sleep and weather. 60s for highs after 50s for lows around the Monterey Peninsula, and just a tad warmer at the north end of the bay with a few 70s cropping up. And we might nudge around the 80-degree mark up in the Santa Cruz Mountains. Evening clear, night gets clouds, patchy fog a little bit later on. That burns off, and we'll call it mostly sunny tomorrow with a little bit of a sea breeze. And we'll likely do that for the next couple of days. And then, like I say, gradually nudge some numbers up. Probably see 80s and 90s by Thursday and Friday in the valleys. Next weekend, it'll be a little bit warmer. And the beaches get a little bit out of it. But it's going to be about perfect weather for the rodeo this year, I think. Again, we'll have a little bit of fog and a little breeze. But nobody, horses don't like it when it's really hot, do they?
I like it just right.
Okay, we'll give them that.
Just right, a little fog. That's all right.
Because she's our horse expert here.
Yeah. We'll keep everyone posted on their big week forecast.
You bet.
Thank you, Jim.
Okay,
appreciate it.
You're welcome.